So it's 2020 and you want to become a game developer, but the problem is you don't know which game engine to learn. Well, this is my list of top 5 game engines to learn in 2020 in no particular order, so let's get started. I'm going to start with Unreal Engine, because if you heard about game development, then you heard about Unreal Engine. Unreal Engine is a game engine developed by Epic Games, first showcased in 1998, so 22 years ago. Unreal Engine is regarded as one of the best game engines because of its graphics capabilities. Some of the more popular titles that have been built in Unreal Engine are Fortnite, the Borderlands series, Rocket League, the Gears of War series, BioShock, and others. You can use Unreal Engine to create a game for any platform, be that mobile, desktop, or console. The pros of Unreal Engine is that you don't have to learn programming in order to create games because it offers the so-called blueprint system, which is visual coding. You basically drag nodes around to create functionality in your game. And this is a very easy starting point for beginners because blueprints are easy to learn and they will provide a solid foundation if you want to learn C++ after that. With blueprints, you can create pretty much any game that you imagine, but they are limited in their functionality because you don't have a way to modify their behavior. And if you want to have full control over every aspect of your game, you can use C++. C++ is the fastest programming language when it comes to game development, but it can be a little hard to start with if you're a complete beginner. That's why I advise people to either learn another, easier programming language like Java or C#, or learn Unreal's blueprint system before they start learning C++. I'm not saying it's impossible to learn C++ from complete scratch, but it is a lot easier if you already know the basics of programming or blueprints. The cons of Unreal Engine is that the learning community is very small. The lack in tutorial examples can be an obstacle for complete beginners who want to learn Unreal Engine, especially the C++ side of Unreal Engine, because the tutorials for that are very rare. That's why I'm going to be humble now and recommend my channel for learning Unreal Engine, as I have both C++ and Blueprint tutorials. Next on the list is Godot or Godot game engine. Godot or Godot, however you want to pronounce it, is an open source game engine that is good for creating 2D and simple 3D games. Godot hasn't been around as long as some of the other engines on this list, and there really haven't been any super successful games made with the engine. So the games like Stereo Break, Deep Sixth, Crushers Bears might not sound familiar, but they are amazing games created with Godot engine. Unlike Unity and Unreal, Godot is flexible when it comes to programming languages you can use to create games with the engine. You can use GDScript, which is a Python-like programming language, and when Godot first appeared, this was the programming language it used. But because Godot is open source, meaning anyone can contribute to its development, the community decided to incorporate C# as well. Both of these languages are easy to learn and beginner-friendly, and Godot, overall, is a beginner-friendly game engine. But with all the pros, there are some cons as well. As we already mentioned, Godot is not powerful as Unity or Unreal Engine, but again, that doesn't mean that you can't create amazing games with Godot. The community is fairly new because Godot is a new game engine, so same as with Unreal, there are not that many tutorials out there that will teach you how to use Godot engine. But again, I'm going to be humble and recommend that you learn from my channel because I have Godot tutorials and I plan to publish more. Next on the list is Unity, the lifelong rival of Unreal Engine, because people argue all the time which game engine is better, Unity or Unreal. And while both game engines are the top game engines, both serve a different purpose. Whereas Unreal is best suited for more robust games, especially from a graphic standpoint, Unity is more versatile and can be a better option for developers who are looking to build mobile games, 2D games, or story-driven 3D games. To get an idea of how versatile Unity is, here is a sample of some of the best games made with Unity: City Skylines, Kerbal Space Program, Hearthstone, Escape from Tarkov, The Room series, and others. While Unreal Engine uses C++, Unity runs its games on C#. C# is the second best programming language for game development, right after C++. But C# is more beginner-friendly, and it's a programming language I recommend beginners learn before they dive into C++. Unity also introduced visual scripting that is going to be part of the engine, but it is still in development mode and it will need some time to match Unreal Engine Blueprint system. So if you decide to go with Unity, I recommend that you dive into C# because it's a beginner's friendly programming language and it gives you more control over your games than what the visual scripting system would allow you to have. Unlike Unreal, the side where Unity shines is its community and the amount of resources available online. You can find tutorials from the complete beginner level topics up to the most advanced stuff. And again, I'm going to be humble and recommend my channel for learning Unity, as you have tutorials that will teach you how to create mobile games, PC games, first-person shooter games, and much more. The fourth game engine I recommend is GameMaker Studio, and this is probably the easiest game engine to use out of all mentioned game engines so far. GameMaker does support 3D game development, but it is really best suited for building 2D games. Some examples of games that have been created with GameMaker Studio are Spelunky, Undertale, Hyper Light Drifter, and Hotline Miami, which is my personal favorite. With GameMaker, rather than having to write scripts or lines of code, GameMaker allows you to drag and drop your game into existence. Of course, it also offers its own language called GameMaker Language, or GML, which is very similar to JavaScript, that you can use to program your own functions and behavior of your game. Another good thing about GameMaker is that the community is large and you can find learning resources. And no, I'm not going to recommend my channel because I don't have tutorials on my channel, but you can find them easily online. And these are the pros of GameMaker. The cons of GameMaker is that you have to pay for every platform you wish to export your game, be that mobile, desktop, or console. So the final cost can stack pretty high depending on which platforms the game is planned to launch on. Last but not least is CryEngine. Like Unreal Engine, CryEngine is another game engine that is built for developing visually stunning games. And as a proof, here is a list of some of the more popular games built with CryEngine. The Far Cry series, the Crysis series, Kingdom Come Deliverance, and Sniper Ghost Warrior. What's good about CryEngine is that it provides the option to use C# or C++ to develop games. Depending on your needs or skill level, you can use whichever language you wish. This also means that even if you are a complete beginner, you will be able to pick up C# easily, and if you already know how to code, you will learn C++ faster. The downside of CryEngine is that the community is very small. CryEngine does provide plenty of free learning resources, although their effectiveness is debatable. So finding good learning resources might pose the biggest challenge when it comes to CryEngine. And again, I'm not going to recommend my channel because I don't have CryEngine tutorials, but you can find them online. And there you have it. This is my list of top 5 game engines that you should learn in 2020. And depending on what you want to do, because probably some of you guys want to create mobile games, others want to create desktop games. For consoles, you need special permissions, you need to be a good developer like I am, apparently, and then you will be able to create games for consoles. But these two, PC or mobile, depending on which one you want, then select the game engine you want. So generally, for mobile games, you should go with Unity and Godot because they are a little bit better. Unity more than Godot because Godot is fresh and new. I don't know how much stable is their mobile version of the code and stuff like that. But for more robust games, more graphics, better looking games, Unreal is the way to go. But please keep in mind, if you are a complete beginner, do not start with C++ because it can get hard. And again, I'm not saying that you can't learn it, but first learn the basics of programming or go into the blueprint side of Unreal Engine. That way it will be much easier and it will cut out probably around 6 months of you painfully trying to learn. So these are my 5 cents, and yeah, check out my Ultimate Game Development Academy. Link will be in the description below, and like this video, double smash the unlike button, or if you don't like it, the button down, and yeah, we'll see you guys in the next one.
If you like this video, don't stop now. Keep learning. Click on these videos that are on my side that are specifically selected for you. So just click on one of these videos and continue watching.